Hello all again. Today we are going to modify a floppy drive to work on IBM machine. Here is two IBM drives, normal drives. You see, there is the 34 pin connector and there is no power for them. I have tried to repair this drive as putting caps here and caps here. So I have tried to fix this, but no. There is no hope for that drive, but instead of that drive, I have managed to these two caps here. I managed to revive this IBM server with this drive, what is took from that machine there. I have borrowed it and fixed it, and now I have managed to get it working. But anyways, these are Alps drives, you see the motor is Alps, very very nice, and 12 volts, and yes. So I was trying to see my floppy collection. I have a lot of them there, and I found this one where it has no front panel, but the button is wrong size because it is a lot smaller, the blue button. I have other drive where the button fitted pretty well, but the drive didn't work it, so I dumped it anyways. I'm not going to fix those drives. So what we are going to do, this button thing, if we get this drive working, this button need to be Dremeled. I can do it later. I have here these instructions, wordpress.com, PS1 stuff, wordpress.com, and there is a good instructions there. I have other site as well where there is needed to good, and it's the same, but this is very good one. Since this floppy has already one pin off, there is no pins, it's the right one, and these two pins, these two next pins, sorry about the sound quality of this mobile phone. It is Samsung Galaxy 5 Neo. Very terrible microphone. Anyways, these two pins what needed to cut as well. They are... Why I cannot get the focus working? There is it. They are these two here. I try to measure with multimeter. I try to see where the traces go, and I cannot find them. So only thing what this might be is they are not connected. I'm going to unsolder them and see what is going on there. Other thing is, this should be all grounded on this other side, and they are not grounded, so I'm going to take a risk and try it what happens without grounding them, this whole side, like on this drive. They are all grounded, and here they are not grounded. I have found other instruction where is needed to ground this all. but not big thing can happen here. They are signal levels, and if you do not put voltage them, I don't think anything terrible will happen. We just need to try it. So next I will unsolder this and clean them to see a little better if there is any trace. If there is any trace, I will cut them on this side, of course, and then I will lead from this pin. This is 5 volt pin to here, where is needed to take the voltage. And this is 12 volts, and that is not in use on this drive because I found one instruction where it is supposed to be easier to modify this drive if there is no 12 volts in use. So let's use a drive where it was only 5 volts in use. Okay, there is the drive now. Just going to unsolder those pins and see what happens there. There is the first one. There is the second one. Yeah, they are now cleaned from the solder. Now I'm going to take picture with my other phone. And now we see here how is it. But here is it, another picture. I clean it up a little better. So these two pins, this lead goes here. This underneath the white goes here, and this underneath the white goes here. So these two cut, and that's it. Simple, very very simple. So this and this, so these two, and they are in very good place to cut. There is no problems to cut them. They are so tiny, but I just use my knife to cut them, and then multimeter after that to verify they are not leading anything. So if I want to put them back working, I just solder them a jumper wire. So I have no break of this drive by doing this. There is it. Let's show. These two here has gotten like that. Now I'm going to verify them. Nothing and nothing, yeah. So they are now cut. All three leads are now cut. What is the instruction saying? instructions saying.
First, remove
the plastic, get a new drive. Careful, remove front plastic, blah blah blah. Blah 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 blah. 5 volt wire and 2 remaining black wires are ground. Now connect wires and solder. So, let's just to see the red wire. Is there, and this yellow wire, what is 12 volts, there is nothing connected on it, and we can see on this side, this is not double sized, this is not double sized, so yes, we are going to make a jumper cable from here to here. As we don't have the pin there, the pin number 3, we cannot solder the 5 volt. We need to do a new rail. So this is not going to be so easy what I was thinking. Next thing is I will going to do a new rail. Easy as that. I need to look up some connectors and do a new wire. Have this IBM model B70. Why the focus will not work? Yeah, there is B70. So the floppy drive thing. I have this cable. As I modified the floppy drive, there is no 5 volt pin, so I'm going to cut the wire and connect it inside of the case. It's the easiest way, so I just cut the wire like this and I connect it. I don't have any place where to position the camera, so I try to do something about it. Okay, I got the camera there, so we continue to cut the wire like this, and we need to find out where we get the current, where is the voltage, 5 volts. Wires here, they are coming from power supply. I will order these ones. I just rope the voltage from there. Yes, no wire. There is. Wire is there now. What a mess, I must say. So it's here now, and now I gently route from here to here. I cut there, maybe again. Too long wire. So we need to find out the schematics, where is the voltage, or we just probe them. Red wire, 5 volts red, orange wire, 12 volts orange, minus 12, blue. So there is 5 volts. Every red wire has 5 volts. It's enough for me now. So we connect it to red wire. Red to red, and back to black. Going to show a bit, there is the wires for the floppy drive. I can put this here, and there is the CPU. It's 20 megahertz 386, and DX, so it has math processor on it. And here is the network adapter, ICOM Etherlink. There is the 8 megs of the RAM, what I need to find out more. Here is the hard drive connector, go here. Here is the screen connector. Underneath here is the screen. Yeah, it came. Yeah, 386 IBM P70. This is how it's like from inside. I don't know if the I have a lot of jumper cables. I should even do more jumpers, but I'm gonna take a risk and try. It will only say wrong ID if there is something wrong. They are related to ID setting, those wires. Before that we really should measure the power, I think. Okay, let's do it. Power. We also need a reference disk. We don't have one now. It is working, but the motor is not spinning. So we have wrong ID, I guess, or we need a disk. Okay, let's see. Yes, it's working. check disc. It's okay. Gear is okay. Next we need to get the reference disc and get rid of the errors, because there is a lot of error.
Well, at least it is reading it. Oh yeah, it is booting from it.
We see now if we get all errors off. No errors, nothing happens. There came 164, 163 error. There is a network adapter. I got correct ADF for the network card. I'm gonna to press Ctrl Delete to reboot it to show I managed to get this PC working with the diskette drive. Yes. How nice. Yes, it's the Finnish version of the DOS. I'm going to show something nasty. The version. I guess no one has seen this version of the DOS. This is a very, very rare version. I don't know if anyone has seen 6.3 version of DOS. So, here is the floppy drive. What to do to get it working on IBM 386 P73? I have already this working unit. There is needed to solder this wire number 4. It is needed, and all of those should be grounded, so I will just close them, because I have opened them and tried the drive on other PC and it didn't work there, so I just close them here, simple as that. There is this one is still disconnected. It should work like this. It was open. It worked like those certain pins open. So I need to find some other way to put this wire. Let's put it like this way. Where this wire go? To the middle of the connector, it's the negative lead of the power. It's the negative lead on the power, and it goes to the pin 4 of the floppy. So this is how you modify the normal floppy drive for the IBM. Yeah, normal floppy drive. I have put the case on. Sorry about the interruption of the video. It's the disk space of the cell phone. It's a Mitsu. It works fine. This is how do you do normal floppy drive to put it working on the P70. It is not rocket science. You just put the current, you deal with the power and see the signal levels. And that's it. It will work. It will boot. It will load. It will do everything. Just be sure your floppy drive is working on a regular PC before you put it on IBM or start doing this. And check the caps. If they are those metallic aluminium caps, change them because they will leak. And that's it. There is it, the wall machine mounted. This is a bit, I need to open this because the blue button, I need it to. This works anyway. Windows 98 boot disk, let's see if that works. Nope, 386, it will not work on that. There is no light, nothing for the floppy. There is a light, but I don't know if that works. Let's see. Yeah, it works. Thank you for watching. Subscribe if you want to see more messing up videos. Thank you for all. See you all next time. It works. Type number there. Yeah, I don't have the wire connected. I have this BNC cable to the network card. It takes some time to load Windows because it's searching for network and the cable is not connected. But it works. Even IRC works, Internet Relay Chat. So, yeah. It is taking time. Got the DHCP message. We cannot get IP address. So it's loading now without the IP. Nice color plasma display. Huh. Why this is taking so long time? I maybe need to put more RAM. It's only 20 megahertz. I was thinking about to change the CPU to 33 megahertz. I have one spare there. But I have no idea if that works. It's alive! Yeah. it's 8 megs, mm. Of course, 386 is the virtual memory. I don't know why this is so slow. Yeah.
This game last time hanged.
This has nice sound. Where is the speaker? I need to find out why this game is not working. It loads and then hangs. Only way exit is Ctrl Delete. No, not even control delete. Power switch is only exit. Well, I guess this was successful.